Good morning, students. Welcome to Teacher A class. Are you ready for our lesson today? Let's begin. Today we are going to review all the things in winter, all the things that we see, the clothes that we wear, and the fun thing we do in winter. Let's begin. Okay, let's start. Winter season vocabulary. Do you still remember the words that we learned about winter season? Okay, you answer this one. What do you call this thing that you see only in winter and its color white? What do you call it? Snow? Are you sure? Okay, let's see. Very good. Snow. Let's spell the word snow. S-N-O-W. Snow. Say, I see snow in winter. Okay, one more time. I see snow in winter. Okay, next word, what can you do in a snow, with snow? What can you do? Okay, look at the two kids. What are they doing? They are making snowball. Very good. Everybody say snowball. Good job. Let's spell the word snowball. S N O W B A L L. Snowball. Repeat after me. I can make snowball made of snow. I can make snowball made of snow. Good job. What do you feel? What do you feel in winter? Or when the weather is cold, what do you feel? Okay, look at the man. He feel what? Is he feel hot? Or he feel cold? Very good. Cold. Cold. The man feel cold. One more. The man feel cold. Great job. Okay, how about this one? This is one of the fun thing to do in winter, right? What do you call this? Do you call this one? Do you call this thing? Sled. Okay, very good. Sled. Let's spell the word sled. S-L-E-D. Sled. I play sled in winter. One more. I play sled in winter. Good job. Okay. Aside from snowball, we can make, what is this? Snowman. Very good, everyone. Let's spell the word snowman. S-N-O-W-M-A-N. Snowman. Snowman. I can make snowman made of snow. One more. I can make snowman made of snow. Very good. And what do you call this thing? The long clothes that we put all over our neck to cover it. Do you call this thing? Scarf. Very good. Scarf. S-C-A-R-F. Scarf. I wear scarf to cover my neck. I wear scarf to cover my neck. Good job, everyone. And repeat the word. Repeat with teacher I. Everybody say snow. Snow. Good job. Snowball. Snowball. Cold. Cold. Sled. Sled. Snowman. Snowman. Scarf. Scarf. Great job. So teacher, I prepare activity. Let's answer it together. Are you ready? Let's answer the activity I prepare for you. Okay, this activity is matching. So as you can see, on the top, you will see 6 words. Below, you will see images or pictures of the thing you see, the thing you wear in winter. Let's start, students. Number one word. Which in the picture is the word cold? Everybody look at the picture carefully. Which in the picture is cold? Is it letter P, letter L, letter J, R, H, or letter D picture? What is your answer? Letter H. Everybody say letter H. Let's check your answer, students. Very good. You got the correct answer. Word number one is picture H. Let's proceed to word number two. Word number two is snow. Which in the picture is snow? What is your answer? R. Are you sure? All right. Everybody say letter R. Let's check it out. Wow. Great job, students. You got again the correct answer. Let's proceed to word number three. The word is sled. Which in the picture is the word sled? Is it letter P, L, J, or D? Letter D. Are you sure? Okay, let's check. Wow, very good. Let's proceed to picture number four. Snowman. The word number four is snowman. Which in the picture is the word snowman? J, are you sure? All right, let's see. Very good. Snowman is picture J. Let's proceed to picture number five. The word is scarf. Which one is the word scarf? Which in the picture? Letter B. Wow, are you sure? Yes, if you are sure, let's check. Great job. The word scarf is picture B. Let's proceed to the last word. The word is snowball. Which one is snowball? L. Let us check, students. Very good. You got all the correct answers. Great job, students. Okay, now I want you to get your worksheet book, students. All right. You're going to cut and paste and trace. Do not forget to write your name here, below your nickname, and your grade level. First thing to do is trace the word. Okay, you have to trace first the word. Next, cut the images and paste them next to their names. Remember? Okay, you only cut the picture or the images. Images. You don't need to cut the whole paper. Do you understand, students? Again, trace the words first and then cut the images and paste them next to their names. Do you understand, students? Very good. You may start doing it now. That's all for today, students. Teacher, I will see you again on Monday. Do not forget to wear your mask when you go out and to wash your hands properly. Have a great weekend, everyone. Keep safe. Bye-bye.